fresh off the ice. We've got Vince Dunn joining us of the Seattle Kraken. Happy New Year to you. What was this experience like playing in front of 48,000 fans?
I don't think it could have gone any more perfect for us. The city did a great job putting this together like they did with our team from the start. So I think just everyone showed up today to play. The crowd was in it till the very end. And shout out to everyone who put this together. They did an amazing job. As you look around right now, they didn't take any shortcuts. So it's very special to be a part of it.
The ice looked great. What did it feel like on ice level?
Yeah, it was great. All things considered, I think with the overcast, it couldn't be any more perfect weather to play in. So I think both teams could definitely agree on that.
That's Seattle Kraken hockey, in my opinion. That's your guys' MO. That's execution. That's how you're built. Is that one of your most perfect games this season?
Yeah, definitely close to it. I think we've definitely been playing a lot better as a team lately, and it shows tonight. I think both teams had their chances tonight. Joey played great in the pipe, so it's just a great overall win for our organization.
The result is great, but the whole weekend, the experience, right, having the friends and family and stuff, now that it's come full circle with a victory, what was the whole experience like for you?
Yeah, a lot of distractions and preparation to make this happen for all of us. I just think that we have all of our families here and friends, so to have them all here and to celebrate with them, it's going to be even more special after this one.
I mean, it's all the experience, like you said, with the family, friends, and you want to have those memories, but did it feel a little business? I mean, you guys are right in the middle of a good run here, but you kind of played yourself back into the playoff contention. Did it feel like once today happened, it's like business as usual?
Yeah, absolutely. I think as much as it was going to be a fun experience, there was definitely a lot of business on the line, and we took care of that tonight. So that's a good feeling for our team to keep moving with the confidence and the wins we've been building here lately.
Speaking of all business, Dave Haxtell said prior to the game that not really worried about New Year's, not really celebrating anything. Is there anything planned tonight for the boys or for your families, for everybody to finally soak it all in?
Yeah, I think last night was kind of tough. We were all staying in a hotel and we're away from our families. So I'm sure lots of guys will get together tonight, whether they do their own thing or they get together with a couple of the boys.
Awesome. You mentioned the families, and it feels like this city has become a family to this organization. See all the fans right here. What do you think this day, this event, means for the city of Seattle?
Yeah, we not only play for ourselves in the locker room, we play for all these people screaming right now. It's amazing. Every single night they show up. They've been here since the start of the organization here in Seattle, so they've always been behind us, and we owe them everything.
How about that guy right there, Joey Decord? Cool story. I mean, I love when you got guys that have battled for playing time, and this is a cool stage for him to shine as well.
Absolutely. He's done a killer job. You can see the crowd absolutely loves him. He's always electric getting into it with them and interacting with them, and very vocal guy on the ice and in the dressing room, so he's fit in perfectly for us and done a great job behind us.
I mean, not unlike we heard with Vegas, some of the guys that got taken in that draft, same thing with you guys. There's a lot of guys like Joey Decord that have this opportunity to make a name for themselves in a new city. And do you see that throughout your lineup? I mean, you especially, you've really taken off. It's been so much fun to watch. That's got to be pretty prevalent throughout your lineup, right?
Yeah, I think when we all came here, we all had something to prove. Some of us were a little happy to get selected by Seattle, and I'm sure some of us were a little bit bummed to leave the team they were comfortable with. So lots of opportunity for myself. I've just tried to take a hold of it whenever I can. My coaching staff and my teammates have put me in very easy places to succeed. So I'm really happy that everything's gone really well for me, and so for Joey too. He's done a great job coming in here. Not the easiest job, especially when the team was struggling a little bit. So I'm really happy for him.
You just touched on it with just, I mean, we've had the luxury here watching you in the playoffs and being in St. Louis and watching your career kind of evolve and getting more of a chance, getting that big deal too, big contract in. And, you know, is this, you're the guy. Like, you're the guy in a lot of different ways. Was it feel extra good for you because of the grind to kind of get more, right? And you're always working for more, and here you are, a big leader on this team.
Yeah, I think I always knew I had more to give, and now to have a little bit more pressure on me and dependence on me to show up every night to be a big part of this team, I'm so happy to do that. And like you said, just to come in here and get the opportunity and grab a hold of it, I've just tried to take advantage of that whenever I can. And the city, the fans, and the organization has been so good to me, and I'm so thankful to be a part of it.
I know Boiler was talking about that was Seattle Kraken hockey. You guys are playing some of your best hockey of the season right now. 5-game winning streak, 9-game point streak. Did you feel like when things weren't going right to start the season that you guys were way off, or you were just a little bit off? And now that you have that fixed, like, it's got to be feeling pretty good.
Yeah, like you said, things weren't going well, and I think we found ourselves digging a bigger hole than we needed to when things were kind of declining. And I've talked about it before, but our team is very close in the dressing room, and I think that's kind of important to get out of those slumps. We didn't back down on each other, and we've always had each other's back. So it's just a matter of time to pick things up.
Hey, I want to ask you real quick, both you guys. You both had Yanni Gord as a teammate. Is he annoying in practice? Like, when he picked the pocket out there, like, this is a guy I would just imagine in practice. You're just like, would you stop? Would you turn it off for 2 seconds?
I'll give you my perspective, Yanni Gord. He is so positive and so happy in the room. And he was more, he'd just gotten called up. He had just broken through. Now, this guy was in the East Coast Hockey League, the American League. And he was really overlooked a lot. And so he got into our locker room in Tampa. And he was just so happy to be there. And he played with so much excitement that, yeah, he might have been a pain in the neck in practice, but you couldn't fault him for it, for what he had to overcome. Now, I don't know. He's got his bank account's a little bit different, and it's well-earned. Maybe he does get a little ornery in the room. I want to hear what his thoughts are, if he's the same guy.
Yeah, his energy and his excitement is kind of contagious in the locker room, and that's a good thing for us. But I think just the way he plays out there, he's very sporadic and catches defenders off guard a little time, the way he pounces on pucks, and he's so aggressive. So he's been a great guy for us in the locker room, being a veteran guy now, and knows what it takes to win, playing in Tampa there. So I think he's just done a great job fitting in and definitely being a loud vocal guy for us. He's someone that keeps it loose when we need to, but also very demanding and knows how to be a leader on the team.
You have him and he's won, right? You've had other guys that have been different places and gone on stretches. You've been on another team that's had success too, but a stage like this, you guys aren't where you wanted to be at this point in the season necessarily. Last year, you know, you make it through to the second round. Did you use this game as almost like, it's time now to show everyone who we are and show ourselves who we are? Was that sort of a motivation?
Absolutely, especially the team we're playing against, the former champs. So there's no better team to do it against and no better atmosphere to do it in. So I think we definitely made a statement tonight. It's great for the confidence rolling into the next game here in the new year.
Who pulled off the Pike Place costume the best, do you think, on arrivals?
Lars kind of looked
Lars
the part.
Was a little funky with that thing on, so yeah, the hats definitely made it a little bit more.
Those rentals, or do you own them now?
No, we get to keep them, actually.
Hey, hey, streaky, right? Look good, feel good, play good. Vince, we appreciate your time. We've taken up way too much of your time. Get in there, celebrate with your guys. Happy New Year, and thanks so much.
Happy New Year. Thank you, guys.